Hey guys, it's your girl Naturally Nata here, and I'm here today to discuss this wig that I got. It is my first wig. It is a Bobby Boss wig. I will have where you can get this wig in the description below, but I just want to show you guys how I got this look. Alrighty, so I started off on freshly washed hair, and I did deep condition it because I'm going to be, you know, wearing a wig for a while, probably about a week. So I want to make sure my hair is nice and moisturized and hydrated and conditioned. So I started out with my hair split in the middle, and I'm just going to cornrow my hair to the side. So I'm taking that super big rake comb that I got at the beauty supply for like $1.50, and I'm using Cantu Coconut Curling Cream. I have done the LO in the LOC method already, so I'm using this curling cream as the C. So I'm taking some gyro edge control and just to smooth out my edges for this front cornrow. I don't do this to all of them, just the front two cornrows, just to slick down the edges. So now, starting with three pieces at the top, I'm just going to begin to cornrow my hair down the side. I just learned how to cornrow. This is my first time ever cornrowing my hair. I watched a couple YouTube videos. Shout out to Maria Antoinette, if you guys know who she is. And another like Black Beauty Tips video that really, really helped me. And yeah, from watching those two videos a couple times, I just figured out how to cornrow my hair. And it's really not that hard. This is not perfect. This is kind of rough because it's my first time, but I plan to get better. So as you can see, I'm just cornrowing my hair all the way down. And the carving turn a 5-star hotel to a trap house. Roaches everywhere, like we forgot to take the trash out. Flood my cross with ice, getting money, my religion. Got my baby mama in my side, kissing. I turn a wrist into a lean house. And then when I get to the end, I just twist my ends instead of doing it all the way down. Just don't want to put any stress on the ends of my hair, so I just twist them. And then I'm just going to repeat that process of parting a section out. And you want to make sure your hair is out of the way, because you don't want to end up pulling hair from different sections. So you have to take the time to actually put your hair back. And then I take some of that coconut curling cream and smooth it through. I take a generous amount, and then I'm just going to comb out any tangles. And then starting at the top, I'm just going to get three sections and go ahead and twist my hair. I'm so used to saying twist. Cornrow my hair all the way down.
I just took some mileage with us. Got some violence with us.
Alrighty guys, so as you can see, I finished both sides. I did 4 cornrows on each side, and it was a struggle, but I got it done. And now I'm just going to pin my hair up in the back. It's really important to just get your hair flat on the top. When, you know, in the back of my head, you really can't really see because it is a bob. It's kind of, you know, volumized in the back anyway. So I'm just going to pin my hair in the back, the long parts of the braids. So I twisted 2 of them together, the first 2. And then I just pinned them behind my head. And now I'm twisting the last 2 together. And I'm just going to pin those up behind my head also. Just wrap them around some of the cornrows on the other side. And just any way you can, just pin them up in the back. This is not going to look very neat, but it really doesn't need to. Try not to rip your ends out, but just pin everything up back there. And now I'm just going to do the same thing to the other side. I'm twisting the first 2 cornrows. And I'm just bringing them under the bottom 2 cornrows. And I'm just going to pin them up some type of way in the back of my head. As you can see, it's not neat. It's really not that pretty, but I just want to keep my hair up and out of the way. And I want to keep the top of my hair looking as flat as possible, the top of my head. So putting in the bag is the easiest thing to do. And you can see how much hair I have, and this wig look still worked for me. So it's possible, which I was doubting if it was possible, but it is possible to wear a wig no matter the length or the thickness of your hair, as long as you can get it flat as possible. So now I'm just going to let my hair dry like this. I turn a wrist into a lean house. This is 6 times getting kicked out. So my hair has fully dried. This is my wig cap. I had put it on, but I forgot. I probably should show you guys how my hair looks at when it's dried. So this is how it looks. And I'm just going to put that wig cap back on, which makes my hair even flatter and even more compact to my head. And now I'm just going to take some more of that gyro edge control just to slick down my edges before I put the wig on. And a toothbrush. Toothbrush is the only way to apply edge control, man. And I just want to explain that this is a synthetic wig that I'm about to put on. It was like $20, literally $23.99, I believe. And synthetic wigs, they are not, you know, the best quality as a human hair, but it is so much more affordable. And for this being my first time, I wanted to see how it worked out. And as long as you take care of them, they could last for at least 6 months, I've heard. And as you can see in the inside of this wig, there is no clips in this one, but it has the adjustable like bra strap things, and I adjusted it to fit my head already. And this is how it looks with the wig on. So I'm going to, this is a wig brush that I got from the beauty supply for like $4. So I'm using that to brush the wig down, get it in place. I didn't do anything really to this wig. It's not a lace front or anything. So it doesn't really have that part that you would have to make look more natural. And I think that's because it is such a low dollar wig. But it still looks really cute. And just to take down some of that shine that's on the wig, this is my first time wearing it, so I'm just going to take some baby powder and sprinkle that on the wig brush. And I'm going to brush that through the hair just to make it a little bit less shiny. This is the finished look, guys. Let me know what you guys think. I'm going to have other wig videos coming about lace front wigs and other wig topics. I'm kind of into wigs right now. I love the whole thing about becoming somebody completely not yourself. Wigs are making me like really happy right now. So I'm going to have more wig topics up. And I love how you can have natural hair, but you can still rock a wig that is, you know, straight hair with color just to switch up your look. And it is a good protective style just to not have to manipulate your hair for a week or so. So thank you guys for watching. Thank you to all my new subscribers. I'm so excited you're here. And I'll see you soon.
I turn the Ritz into a pole house. It's like eviction number 4.